A matrix diagram is a tool used to arrange and display information in order to help you understand important relationships and make decisions. It can be used in a number of different ways to help you make decisions for action. For example, imagine you're looking at a list of change ideas. You know you have only so much capacity, and you want to be thoughtful about where to start. You might use a matrix diagram like this. Let's draw this out. So what I can do here is basically say, okay, I've got my different ideas, and with my team, I can look and say, well, gosh, let me think about this here for a second. So with idea one, on a scale of 1 to 5, you know, how much do we think this can be done in say a 90-day time frame? We might look at that and say, oh gosh, well, I can only do this may take longer than 90 days. I'm not sure, so maybe I'll give that one a 2. On idea two, though, I think this one totally could get done in 90 days. And idea three, there's probably a high likelihood. Okay, great. Well, let me think about will to fix this problem. Is this important to people? I might come here and say, well, you know, there's a lot of will here. For an idea one, there's actually quite a bit for idea two, but idea three, you know, it's something that people aren't ready to work on yet. And then as I look at things that I have control to make changes on, I might come across and say, okay, great. So there's this again, maybe it's moderate level to control the changes. This one, I pretty much completely in my control, and idea three is not in my control at all. And then sponsorship, I look and you know, idea one, there's a sponsor who says that this would make sense, and they'll look at it. There's good sponsorship for idea two, and there's kind of limited sponsorship, moderate sponsorship for idea three. So as I'm looking at my matrix, now I can and kind of look at my data and say, well, which of these ideas has the best chance of success, right? And in this particular case, as I look across them, I might decide to select idea two, because I've got a higher degree of belief that it's going to be able to be accomplished in a short amount of time. There's will to improve it. I have the ability or the control to test changes, and there's good sponsorship. So that's a high spot for me to potentially be successful in a project. As you go through the ranking, you hopefully discover that one change idea may be better than another to start with because it possesses more of the factors for success. It also can help you think about where work may need to occur to improve the likelihood of success of other change ideas before you begin to test them. Can you think of where in your project a matrix diagram could be useful?